Hi, I'm Justin, a product manager in Google Search. In the next few minutes, I'll show you an easy new way for event organizers, performers, venues, and ticket sellers to promote their events in Google Search through the Knowledge Graph. The Knowledge Graph is Google's system for organizing information about millions of well-known people, places, and things in the real world. The better we understand these things, the better we can understand what web pages are really talking about and what users are really searching for. The information in the Knowledge Graph comes from lots of sources, like Wikipedia, Google Maps, the FDA for drug data, Music Brains for album data, and so on. But in the case of events, we think the best source of event information is the event organizers themselves. For example, when people ask about Keith Urban's upcoming concert dates, we'd like to give them an authoritative answer from Keith himself or from his official website. Likewise, when people search for what's going on at a local venue, whether that's a music club, a stadium, a theater, or the local library, we think that venue's website is the best source of answers. So that's the basis for our new approach to events in Google Search. We're asking event organizers to take charge of their own events in the Knowledge Graph by adding structured data markup to their official websites. Google can then read this markup as it crawls the web, add it to the Knowledge Graph, and show it to users in Search. So I'm going to show you how easy it is to add that markup thanks to the new JSON-LD format. But before I get to the technical details, let's take a quick peek at one way events from the Knowledge Graph show up in Search. We'll start with a song someone told me about. It's called Alligator Strut. All right, I'm going to Google that song, and I learn it's by Anton Schwartz. Who's he? All right, he's a saxophonist, got a few albums out, he's well-educated, and he's got upcoming events. Let's take a look at those. All right, here's a nice, rich list of events that I can swipe through. I can discover one near me. When I click on it, I get more details, including a map, and I get the ability to click right through to his official website where I can get all the details. Let's learn about this event. Right on with the Boston Symphony. I'm getting a ticket. All right. And that's just one example of how the Knowledge Graph helps people discover events. In addition, the Knowledge Graph powers event-rich snippets in search results, it powers event listings in Google Maps, and it powers notifications in Google Now to automatically inform people of interesting nearby events and when their favorite bands are coming to town. So again, to be eligible for all these cool features, event organizers have to mark up their websites. We pay special attention to data on the official websites of touring performers, like musical artists and comedians, to venues' official websites, and soon to the official websites of annual events like festivals and conferences. Finally, for any event where tickets are sold, we'll also look to the primary ticketer's official website for ticketing details. So, our request for markup on all of these websites is the same. Use the schema.org vocabulary to label the key properties of each event. Schema.org is just a set of standard property names for structured data agreed upon by the major search engines. When Google processes a web page, it can recognize schema.org properties in several different markup formats, including microdata and RDFA. However, in this talk, I'm going to tell you about a new format, JSON-LD. Unlike the other formats, JSON-LD doesn't require you to interleave your structured data with the HTML displayed content. That makes it the most developer-friendly format yet, and Google is embracing it. All right, let's take a closer look. Here's what JSON-LD looks like when embedded in a web page, in this case, Keith Urban's tour page. As you can see, it's just a block of JSON data. The JSON keys highlighted in yellow, like start date and location, are schema.org property names. The whole JSON block should be wrapped in a script tag, and then you can insert it anywhere in the web page, either the head or the body. Okay, let's go through some of the interesting properties here. First, the @type. You should use the most specific subtype of event that applies to your event. Popular subtypes include comedy event, festival, food event, music event, theater event, and sports event. This helps search engines categorize your event, and in some cases lets you specify extra fields relevant to that type of event, such as home team and away team on a sports event. Next, the start date. This needs to be in ISO 8601 format. The time is included in the field, and it's assumed to be in the local time zone of the event location. If the event has a definite ending time, you can specify that using a separate end date property. Next, location. The value of this property is a nested sub-object of type place. In our experience, this type of hierarchical data nesting was really easy for developers to mess up in the microdata or RDFA format. But in JSON-LD, it's very natural. You can see that the place sub-object should have a name property, that's the name of the venue, and an address property. The address can be given as a single string, which Google is good at picking apart, or as a set of individual fields in another nested sub-sub-object of type postal address. There's another interesting property on the place here, same as fiddlersgreenamp.com. This property is designed to help you connect your data to the knowledge graph. The value of the same as property should be a URL that unambiguously indicates the item's identity. For example, the venue's Wikipedia page, Freebase page, or official homepage. In this case, the homepage of Fiddler's Green Amphitheater is provided, which helps Google understand that Fiddler's Green refers to the amphitheater in Colorado, not to the mythical location in the afterlife where fiddlers fiddle and dancers dance for all eternity. So, moving back to the code, we're up to the event's performer markup. Again, note the same as link, this time to a Wikipedia page, ensuring that Google can understand exactly which real-world artist is performing at the event. The same as URLs, by the way, don't have to appear in the user visible portion of the web page. They're only a hint to search engines about how to understand the user visible text. If there are multiple performers at the event, great, use a JSON array to list all of them. Finally, the last key property is offers. This is where ticketing information goes within an offer sub-object. For a ticketed event, the key property to specify is the URL of the web page the user should visit to purchase a ticket to the event. If you specify a ticket link, then behind the scenes, Google will also visit that web page and try to gather more ticketing details from whatever structured data markup we find there. So let's look at what we might find on the ticketer's web page. The rest of the markup should basically be the same, but on the ticket offer, we should expect some extra properties. The category of ticket, such as primary or secondary, the price of admission, the availability status, which should be set to sold out if the event is sold out, and the valid from date, which specifies when these tickets go on sale. So that's how you mark up an event using JSON-LD. Are you done? Just one step left, as every developer knows, testing. To make sure your markup is correct before you deploy it on the web, copy it into Google's newly updated Event Markup Tester. It provides detailed error messages on both syntax problems, like a missing comma, and data problems, like a missing required property or a wrongly formatted date. You can also see a summary of all the markup we found on your website in the Structured Data Dashboard. That's available in Webmaster Tools. And that's all there is to it. When Google next crawls your site, we'll read the marked up events, verify that they're consistent with what users see on the web page, and then import them directly into the knowledge graph for use across Google products. For more examples and documentation, please visit our help page at g.co/structureddata. And after you've got the markup deployed, hey, why not celebrate with a night out on the town? Thank you.